ஸ்ரீகிருஷ்ணா 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 குருர் பிரம்மா குருர் விஷ்ணு குருர் தேவோ மகேஸ்வர குரு சாட்சாத் பரம் பிரம்ம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நம யதாபகிருஷ்டம் சைவாலம் க்ஷணமாத்திரம் ந திஷ்டதி அவ்ருணோதி ததா மாயா பிராஜ்யம் வாபி பராங்முகம். ஒன் மே பி வெரி வெல் ரேட் இன் த ஸ்கிரிப்சர்ஸ் பிராஜ்யம் ஆர் பராங்முகம் ஹூ இஸ் எக்ஸ்ட்ரோவர்ட். தீஸ் மாயா டேக்ஸ் பொசிஷன் ஆஃப் எனிபடி இன்ஸ்டன்டேனியஸ்லி லைக் த மாஸ் ரீகவர்ஸ் த சர்ஃபேஸ் ஆஃப் த வாட்டர் ஹவு மெனி டைம்ஸ் யூ மே ரிமூவ் இட். Now, what is the meaning of Maya? The most misunderstood word, Maya. And wherever there is a Maya, there is importance of name and form. See, if you go to UP, see, the Mayavati will have the statues and the names everywhere. So, what is Maya? Maya means the experiences which are gathered through sense organs and the mind, and mistaking these experiences to be the ultimate, this obsession is called as Maya. Like we can see by our eyes a particular spectrum of light waves. We cannot go beyond that. But when we are insisting, no, unless I see God, I don't believe God. So when you see, then you don't need belief. Belief is required when you are ignorant. See, this is how the Maya works. So whatever I can experience through the sense organs, whatever I can experience through the mind, that alone is the truth. This is called as Maya. The technical meaning of Maya is, Ma means measurement. Char Mahanagro ka Tapman. Tap is temperature. Man is measurement. 30 degrees, 40 degrees, 50 degrees. So, Maya, that because of which the infinite is measured because of obsession of functioning through the means of knowledge. Therefore, avrunoti tatha maya prajnam vapi parangmukham. So, this Mavadna Maya does, when we are under the compulsive influence of the sense organs, organs of action, the mind, the intellect, then we are under the influence of Maya. So we have to get beyond this. If we don't, then we are under the influence of Maya. And Parangmukham. Parangmukham means what? The one who is extrovert, who is wanting to see God. Please be attentive. Truth can be known only as one's own being. Knowing is being. Truth cannot be known as other than the self. All that is known as other than the self is only the projection of the mind. Therefore, such people, those who don't have these basics, they get lost only in imagination. When will I have the vision of God? Yes, God came. In the dream, somebody came and gone. These are all the projections of the mind. Don't get carried away by any emotions. There was a great saint in Lucknow. He is no more. He was from now the present Pakistan, earlier India. Born in sometime 1916. Right in his childhood, when he was hardly 5-6 years of age, he had that kind of experience which he never had. So he became very passionate about that, to repeat it again and again. एंड ही कॉट होल्ड ऑफ भगवान श्री कृष्ण एंड ही बिकेम सो मच इन्वॉल्व्ड सो ही वॉज टॉकिंग वर्चुअली टू द लॉर्ड एंड आफ्टर मेनी ईयर्स येट ही डिड नॉट फाइंड फुलफिलमेंट इन हिज लाइफ देन ही हैपन टू मीट भगवान रमण महर्षि एंड रमण महर्षि डिड नॉट टॉक टू हिम फॉर 3-4 days एंड वन डे ही सेड यस व्हाट यू हैव टू से ही सेड आई कैन टॉक टू भगवान कृष्ण लाइक आई कैन टॉक टू यू एनी टाइम ही कम्स एंड गोज नाउ व्हाट मोर आई हैव टू अचीव सो ही वॉज टोल्ड ड्रॉप दैट कृष्ण बिकॉज एनी एक्सपीरियंस विच कम्स एंड गोज एनी एक्सपीरियंस विच इज थ्रू सम इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ नॉलेज सेंस ऑर्गन्स ऑर्गन्स ऑफ एक्शन और माइंड और एनीथिंग दैट एक्सपीरियंस इज प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ द माइंड वेन अवर माइंड कैन प्रोजेक्ट फ्रेंड एंड एनिमी वेन अवर माइंड कैन प्रोजेक्ट गुड एंड बैड Can't that mind project, I am seeing Krishna, I am seeing Rama? Therefore, those who are emotional, they will not like it. This is okay, okay, Vedanta rakho apne paas. Mujhe to Krishna chahiye, rado. Nobody can help you. Therefore, जीवतो यस्य कैवल्यं विदेहोपि स केवलः समाधि निष्ठतामेत्य निर्विकल्पो भवानग हे अनग ओ सिनलेस वन द सिन इज मिस्टेकिंग अवर सेल्फ टू बी द बॉडी एंड द सोल सो द वन हु हैज ट्रांसेंडेड दिस टू नोशंस दैट आई एम द ग्रॉस बॉडी एंड द सटल बॉडी ऑर द जीवा टू सच अनग इट इज सेड जीवतो यस्य कैवल्यम विदेह विदेहोपि स केवलः द वन हु हैज दस अटेंड फ्रीडम फ्रॉम द रिलेटिव एग्जिस्टेंस ऑल्दो फंक्शनिंग इन द रिलेटिविटी हाउ इट इज पॉसिबल व्हाई नॉट वी आर सिटिंग हियर एंड आई एम टॉकिंग एंड यू आर सीइंग I don't know whether you are hearing or not. So, although sitting, yet not listening, possible. In the same manner, although functioning in the relative world, but not getting influenced by the relativity, is jivato yasya kaivalyam. And how and when can it happen? Only under one condition. When we are on the stage of a drama, we function as a character. We function through the character, but without becoming any character. See? Exactly the same way. We all have to play different roles. Husband, wife, brother, father, mother, sister. Play your role perfectly well. Without getting rolled up in the role. That's it. Therefore, all the problems of our life, they can be answered by one word. Either say, everything is Rama Leela, or say, everything is Krishna Leela. Leela means what? Everything appears to be happening, but nothing is happening. Like our satsang. Appears to be listening. It is so simple, friends. So, jivato yasya kaivalyam videhe opi sa kevalaham samadhi nishthatam eti. And by this practice, when we are leading our day-to-day life, we have to lead every moment of our life as if we are acting. Don't take anything seriously. See, friends, unless our day-to-day activities are having the fragrance of this wisdom, Nirvikalpa Samadhi is not possible. See, friend. Constantly fighting with this fellow, that fellow, argumentation, logic, reason, and I am better than you, I know what you know. Such a person can never be at peace. Therefore, never get lost in any arguments. Vado na avalambyaha. This is the sutra from Narada Bhakti Sutra. Don't take refuge in any arguments. If a donkey calls a horse as a donkey, so to fight with that donkey is becoming a super donkey. Then what to do? Agree before listening. Yes, yes, yes. See? Old people have got certain, you know, limitations. One of the limitations is, old people don't remember what they have said. So recently I was somewhere in Raipur, and there was one very old man, very nice, could not even walk and all that, must be 80 plus or 90 like that. He told me the same thing at least 200 times. And his other people, Swamiji, we are sorry, he is repeating the same thing. I said, why you are sorry, you also repeat. Why? I said, as you don't listen to me, I am not listening to him. But he has got a satisfaction that I am talking. Like I have got a satisfaction that I am talking. See, friends, the same thing he will repeat again and again. Swamiji, you have to come to our town. I'll make all arrangements. When are you coming? And then in between I talk to some other people. He said, yes, Swamiji, when are you coming to our place? I want to invite you. Then again here, again the same thing, you know. You are not given your phone number. I have to invite you. Same thing, again and again and again. So will you go and fight with the old man? No. Yes, yes. That's all. Therefore, these things when we start learning from our experiences, then this knowledge becomes firm. Therefore, jivato yasya kaivalyam. One person wrote me, Swamiji, I was very frustrated, angry, and I decided to leave and I am going away. I said, go. But remember two things. Don't go away with a bitterness in your mind. Don't have any bitter feeling for anybody. And when you cross a bridge, never destroy the bridge. Remember this. Then I told him, you respect me, you love me, is it not? Yes. What is that which makes you happy when you are with me? Is not me, but your respect for me. I don't make anybody happy. Those who respect and revere, they are happy. Those who hate, I am the same, but they suffer. Be attentive. So what is the conclusion? The happiness depends not on the things around us. The happiness depends on how we relate ourselves to the world. If we relate to the world with respectful, reverential attitude, we will be always happy. See, my friends. So when we respect somebody, that body is not benefited. The one who is carrying the atmosphere of respect and reverence in his heart, he or she is benefited. See, friends, these things you don't get in books. You have to work on yourself. So, samadhi nishtata ameti, then such a person alone can attain the samadhi nishta, nirvikalpa samadhi. That means he is now naturally able to be disturbance free in spite of all the din and roar of the battle of life. He will be at अज्ञान हृदय ग्रंथे निशेष विलयस्तदा समाधिना अविकल्पेन यदा अद्वैतमात्मदर्शनम्. सो अज्ञान हृदय ग्रंथे निशेष विलयस्तदा. सो व्हेन वी आर प्रैक्टिसिंग दिस निर्विकल्प समाधि, बी अटेंटिव. Nirvikalpa Samadhi is not sitting like a stone. Vikalpa means option. Will you like to take this or that? Option is given. So, what is the option we have given to ourselves? Whether I am body, whether I am jiva, whether I am paramatma, what option we have given? See? Nirvikalpa Samadhi means no option is given, no doubt of being the non-dual, absolute, conscious, blissful existence. Remaining in this, not only conviction, but experience. Avidya, kama, karma, these three things put together is called as the knot of the heart. And this nishesha vilayastada, this knot of the heart dissolves. This knot is like the necktie knot. When the neck is in the loop, then it ties you. When the neck is not in the loop, you pull it, it opens. Exactly. This is a knot which is not, and yet makes us miserably because she is naughty. See? Hrudaya granthi, avidya kama karma. Therefore, this nirvikalpa samadhi practice is refuse to be anything else other than the divine. That's all. No. How can I be divine? Like, you know, many times I address people, Mahatmaji, please come. And that person is not happy because I called him Mahatmaji. No, Swamiji, where I am a Mahatma. Okay, you fool, you come. The moment I call fool, they become disturbed. Not because I called him fool. But how come Swamiji also knows that everybody calls me fool? Then what are you? Neither you are wise nor otherwise. Then who are you? See, friends. Therefore, ajnana hrudaya granthehe nishesha vilayastada samadhina avikalpena yada advaitamatma darshanam. Then alone we abide in the non-dual absolute self. See, friends. Therefore, the real spiritual practice is not doing anything, but it is a process of undoing. The real spiritual practice is not becoming somebody, but a process of unbecoming. The spiritual practice is not gaining something, but losing everything. सब उल्टा हो गया. Have we come here for a loss? Of course. If we have this notion, what will I get? You get nothing. I promise you. Nothing you will get. If you are ready for this bargain of loss, then jump. But if you want calculation, putrarthi labhete putra dhanarthi labhete dhanam, go to some other place. He will not get it here. Atratmatvam drudi kurban ahamadishu santyajan udasi natayateshu tishten ghatapatadivata. Atra, in this advaita atma darshanam, in this aham atmatvam drudi kurvam. Now be firmly, insist again and again that I am not anyone else but the divine. Again. And for that, one of the biggest thing that most of us suffer from, we are unable to drop our past. Not knowing, past belongs to the body. Body was born, body was child, body was teenage, body was middle age. And when we talk about our childhood here and there, what is unknowingly happening? Our body identification is maintained. I was not a child, the body was a child. I was not a teenager, the body was a teenager. When the teenager died, I did not die. See, friends, that is why we again and again say, don't bring your past in the present. But when we are lost in this relative world, like one elderly man in Varanasi told me, unless we tell our grandchildren how they will know about our past, I said, before you tell them, ask them, are they interested? One old man was telling his grandson, Beta, when we were young, we used to go to the market with handful of money and we used to get a cartload of things. Now you people go with a cartload of money and get a handful of things. The child was smart. He said, Dadaji, you are getting grass for the buffaloes. We are getting the blue chips. See the difference? How important it is. I received one nice picture. One huge lady dressed in blue clothes and a thin husband. And she is caught up by a blue whale. Atratmatam drudi kurvan. Insist that you are divine, you are divine. Then aham adishu santyajan. And this, I am body, I am sinner, I am good, I am bad, I have committed sins, I have committed merit, I was, no need. Try. Don't bring your past. Don't bring your relations in your talks. Nobody. Then what to talk? Can you imagine how many waves per second are erupting on the sea? Keep him busy. You go away. See, we must have the art of changing the topic. This I learned from a child. When I used to ask him anything, he'll change the topic. Swamiji, you have gone to so many places, which place you like? I said, I ask you some question. He said, I also ask you some question. He will never answer that question. See? Instead of fighting and all that, straight away change the topic. So, aham adishu santyajan, give up this wrong notion of your personality, then udasinataya teshu tishthet. Then remain totally indifferent to all the good and the bad that has happened in your life. Anything, anywhere. By this practice, slowly the length of our past starts reducing. Lesser the past length, more innocent and happy you are, like a child. The length of the past of a child is hardly 3 years, 4 years, 2 years. So the child is so innocent, pure, sweet. And oldies like us, the length of our past is 90, 80. And then continuously, jab hum bacche the, who cares? So, udasinataya teshu. I tell you what happens, to what extent it happens. After having taken sannyas, the process of sannyas diksha is, you conduct your own shraddha. Because you are, technically speaking, dead. Because you have conducted your own shraddha. Now, a dead person cannot have bank account. A dead person cannot have a home address. See? A dead person cannot have possessions. And yet, you will see many places they are given sannyas, Swami Gadbadananda. And yet they referred them by their old name. Then what is the use of this new name given? We have to cut with all the past. Where the past names and forms are dropped, a new birth. Therefore, whatever may be your name earlier, it is changed, now you are somebody. And it is suffix with Ananda. One child asked me, why you people write always Ananda? I said, why, is it a monopoly of cinema actor or what, Devananda? Then, it is only because, at least for your name's sake, be happy. See? And then, the name is changed. And then, the form is changed. You people dress a decent way, is it not? We are dressing in a funny way. Once I was in the UK, Cornwall, down south. There was one beautiful mansion or a fort in the sea. In the low tide you can walk, and before the high tide comes you have to come out. So when we were going, there was one small little child told his mom, see man with funny clothes. See? So we change our form, we change our name, so that the total past is erased. Yet, you will see many places, they write, Swami Gadbadananda, bracket, ex-IAS officer. So that IAS is not given up. IAS means, do you know the meaning of IAS? I am sorry. For everything they say, I am sorry, I am. It is not administrative service. So, udasinataya teshu tishten ghatapata adivad. Like the pot or a cloth. Whether the cloth is on a living person or a dead person, whether the cloth is with anybody, it makes no difference to the cloth. Exactly the same way. Be indifferent. Be indifferent. Don't get involved. Brahmadi stambha paryantam mrusha matra upadhayaha tataha purnam svam. Sva-atma-atmanam pashyet ekatmanastitam. All the conditioning right from Brahmadi up to anything, they are mrusha, they have no meaning. Now apply this to yourself. What are our conditioning? Conditioning are father, mother, brother, sister, husband, all this conditioning. Because of this conditioning, one is divided as if into many. So which is the reality? The divided one or the one who is divided? Think. Then what are they? Mrusha. Mrusha means although they appear, they don't exist. There are three things we have to understand. Something is existing, sat. Something is not existing, asat. Something is not existing, yet it appears. That is called as mrusha or mithya. In a school, I was talking to kids to tell this principle. So, to the children, you have to tell in their language. And children are children, even our minds run here and there. How the children can listen? So, I told him, do you see the eyes above my nose? Yes. I said, this is called as existence, reality. It is real. It is there. Yes. Do you see the horns on my head? No, because they are non-existent. Understood? Yes. When I was talking, there was one child totally indifferent. So I caught hold of him. I said, just now I asked a question. You didn't reply. Tell me, are there horns on my head? Not for now. Maybe, who knows, they may grow. So that which is not and yet it appears is called as mithya. is called as an illusion. See, and this illusion covers the substratum. Like when we are looking at the ocean, our attention is on the waves. So the waves are covering the ocean. When we are looking at the ocean is covering the waters. So in fact, we are seeing the waters, but we talk of ocean and the waves. Exactly the same way, ocean and waves have no existence. Existence is the waters. In the same manner, here the teacher says, Brahmadi stambha paryanta mrusha matra upadhayaha. The creator Brahmaji, the ocean, the created the waves, the jiva and the jagat, they are not real. The water is the real. Cause and effect is merely superimposed on the substratum. And that is one of the spiritual practice. Don't get lost in cause and effect. Why? Because the sky is too high. There is no reason to that. Tataha purnam swamatmanam pashyet ekatmana sthitam. Thus, always abide in this. That you are the one. Because of the conditionings, you appear to have become many. See? Once this vision develops, everywhere you will see the same thing. In every experience. See? Like rice is one. Out of that rice, many upadhis. One upadhi calls the rice as idli. The second day, rice takes the second avatar. That is called as the uttamapata, uttapam avatar. The dough is the, what is that, batter is the same. The third day still it is not exhausted. Then it is a dosha avatar. But behind all of them, there is one reality. See? In this manner, tataha purna svam atmanam pashyet ekatmana sthitam. So many experiences have come and gone. Jagra, sapna, sushupti, samadhi, good and bad. Nothing has happened to us. We are ever the same. Like, be attentive, like either the mirror is not influenced by any content reflected or the space which supports everything but doesn't get influenced by anything. Swayam Brahma, Swayam Vishnu, Swayam Indra, Swayam Shiva, Swayam Vishwamidam Sarvam, Swasmad Anyanna Kinchana. Then we come to know Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, they are not somewhere above. You are the Brahma when you create confusion. You are Vishnu when you maintain confusion. And you are Shiva when you destroy your own confusion. You are Indra, you are your own king. And you are Shiva, you are your own peaceful being. Kaivalya Upanishad, Mai eva sakalam jatam, Mai sarvam pratishtitam, Mai sarvam layam yati, tad brahmad vayam asmiham. Everything is born in me. Everything is retained in me, maintained in me. Everything goes back to me. See? If I am not there, my wife has no existence. If I am not there, my property has no existence. Without I, my cannot exist. If this is with the relative world, what to talk about the absolute? Therefore, Swayam Vishwamidam Sarvam. If I am not there, there is no world. If there is no world, there is no creator, Brahma. If there is no world, there is no maintenance department, PWD, Vishnu Bhagwan. There is nobody if I am not there. Colors and forms are born from the vision. Vision is born from the mind. Mind is born from the consciousness. Now what is happening? Colors and forms are covering the vision. The sense organs are covering the mind. The mind is covering the consciousness. So what we have to do? One by one, remove the cover. First, devalue all the worldly objects, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. Second, don't be a slave to your sense organs. Third, don't be carried away by emotions. Fourth, don't be arrogant of the knower of the truth. And when this I, who was struggling to know the truth, he also disappears, what remains is Paramatma. It is the process of going to sleep without entering sleep. How we go to sleep? The same way. We drop the whole world, then we close all our sense organs, then all achievements and failures are kept outside. Then we go below the quilt, everything is closed. And then the last thing, I want to sleep, I want to sleep. Even I and the want, they are dropped. The moment I and the want are dropped, the sleep begins. See? That is why those who sleep in satsanga, they are the real seekers of truth. While listening itself, you are all listening, many are there, they already drop. You keep on talking, we are finished. In the same manner, everything is born out of me, other than me, nothing else is. Svatmani arupita shesha vasa vastu nirasitaham swayameva param brahma purna madvayamakriyam. In this manner, whatever we are superimpose on ourselves, we have to reject one by one, one by one. See? When sannyas is taken, what exactly happens? When the shraddha is conducted, then we are dead. So a dead person doesn't have any relations. Gone. A dead person doesn't have any possessions. A dead person can neither be honored nor be disrespected. And yet, Babaji like us are so arrogant, you know. And small little things are enough to disturb. This happened in Bombay, in one place where my talks are conducted. Normally, they were on the fifth floor. One day when I went, the watchman told Swamiji, today your talks are on the ground floor. I said, okay. I went there. The trustee came, one of the trustees. He said, why are you going there, Swamiji? I said, to see a movie. Now what for I am coming here? Is it a question or what? No, your talks are on the fifth floor. Why you go on the ground floor? I said, your watchman told. Who is he? I said, he's the watchman. Questions have no meaning. No, you cannot go there. We will have it on the first floor. Those TV people, they have fixed their cameras. Everything was done. I want just to sit down and start my lecture. No, we'll go up there. I said, okay. I took a glass of water. No, pani upar pila. How one gets obsessed. And then, by the time everything was done, I went to another room. I told that person, hey, get me some cup of tea. And I was enjoying cup of tea. One person came, he said, Swamiji, why he did like that? I said, go and ask him, don't ask me. How do I know why he did it? No, I am telling you, the other day in the same hall, there was one Swamiji sitting and other Swami came. So how to keep him in the audience? So they requested him, Maharaji, if you move little bit, maybe about 6 inches or 1 feet, this Mahatmaji can sit here. That Mahatma got angry. He got up. He said, forget about it. I am not going to talk to you. And he walked away. And you are fully lifted and taken up there. And how come you are enjoying tea? I said, I am very simple. Because is it that when they were sitting on the ground floor, they were listening. And on the fourth, fifth floor, they will not listen. No, I know. Both the places, they don't listen. Here it is AC, comfort. And therefore they come and I also come for that. That's it. Don't make an issue out of anything in life. See? But for us, small little things becomes a big issue. Therefore, Swatmani Aropita Ashesha Abhasa. This is our own projection that I am great. See, there was one boy who came for a job in one of my friend's place. And he said, I'll do job, said Ji, but I will not take less than 500 rupees per month. So the Sadhguru said, 500 is too much. You should take 200. No, no way. Okay, let us compromise. Make it 300. No, I will not take one pie less. But then I will have to see someone else. I can't afford. Okay, for you, I can make it 350. And that boy agreed. After he went, my friend told me, Swamiji, see, this is how everybody has a value tag to himself. Had he worked sincerely, cheerfully, I would not have hesitated to pay him 1,000 rupees a month. But he has already put a tag on himself. I am 350 per month. See, friend, don't put a tag on yourself. You are infinite. This is how we reduce the infinite to the ridiculous finite. So, Atmeni Ashesha Abhasa Vastuni Nisheshataha Nirasitaha Swayameva Param Brahma. So don't carry that notion, I am Brahmana Kshatriya Vaishyashudra, I am unfortunate. No, 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 you are divine, you are divine. Then, Swayameva Param Brahma, Purnam Advayam Akriyam. Infinite. Therefore, no desires. Therefore, no Kriya. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. Then, what for to leave time pass? The day you will learn my principle of time pass, you have learned the whole of Vedanta Shastra. There is nothing more than this. One day I was sitting having a cup of tea, one girl came. After many years she happened to come and meet me. She said, Swamiji, what are you doing? I said, I am waiting for death. No, 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 don't say like that. I said, no, now you have come. Now tell me, really what are we doing? Are we not simply waiting for death? What else? See, that is all. Here we have come for learning. Time pass. Somehow or the other, this time pass principle, once you take, what happens is, no I is created. See, like when you play with the kids, cricket. So when you are playing the cricket, you are not concerned whether you will win or you are defeated. Till the bell for the lunch or the dinner goes, you have to spend time. So what you do? Well, let us play cricket. Then you have your, like I had my own rule. I said, I'll play on my following rules. I will do only batting. Don't ask me to run. Second thing, I'll never be out. No catch out, no clean bowled. You say, okay. And I did not say any other option. No catch out, no clean board. Okay. And then the boy shouted. He shouted, Swamiji, LBW. Because you did not say LBW. I said, you can't do that because you can't see my legs. How can it be leg before wicket? But he has his option. Swamiji, for you, LBW means lungi before wicket. So you are out. No, I was not concerned whether I win or I get out or not. Till the bell for the lunch goes, time pass. Live with this attitude in life. You are in Nirvikalpa Samadhi. See? This principle, Dukkeshu Anudvignamanaha, Sukeshu Vigatasprahaha, Vitaraga Bhayakrodaha, Stitani Muni Uchate. When miseries come, refuse to be miserable. Yes, miseries come. When comforts are there, don't be enslaved by the comforts. Vitaraga Bhayakrodaha, getting out of this fear, anger, etc., then Stitadhi, then your wisdom will remain steady. What is important in life is not the steady body, but the steady wisdom. The wisdom has to be steady. If the wisdom is not steady, then whatever you may do, it is all waste. Now, असत्कल्पो विकल्पोऽयं विश्वमित्येकवस्तुनि निर्विकारे निराकारे निर्विशेषे विदा कुतः अयं विकल्पः विश्वं दिस् मल्टिप्लिसिटी प्लुरालिटी ऑन द नॉन ड्यूअल वन एब्सोल्यूट सेल्फ इज असत् इज नॉट रियल इट ओनली अपियर्स Now, when we look at the surface of the ocean, there are many waves. But behind the many waves, are there many oceans? Be attentive. Waves are many when you are at the surface. In the same manner, when our life is at the surface level, there will be multiplicity. There will be manyness. And when you dive deep, see? When you are doing that scuba diving, and if you are on the surface wanting to see the corals, etc., the waves will buffet you up and down. But in the same place, if you go deep, not 100 feet, maybe even 10, 20 feet, if you go deep, there are no waves. In the same manner, at the periphery of our personality, there are agitations. When you go deep within yourself, there are no agitations. The journey from the periphery to the center is the spiritual journey. Be attentive. And this center is such a peculiar center. This center doesn't have a circumference. Therefore, this center is everywhere and yet it is nowhere. Come to discover this truth. See, my friends, therefore, such great masters, they are always at home everywhere, because where they are not. We are comfortable only in our room. See? Swamiji, how can you sleep in any place? I said, shall I show you, demonstrate or what? No, unless we have got our bed, our pillow, our quilt, we don't get sleep. Then keep awake, you are already realized. See? Till such time, my house, my building, my thing is there, you will suffer. See? Then there is nothing like, I eat only homemade things. We don't eat outside things. So I told that lady when she was telling. But I said, I have got also rules. I eat only outside things. How come? Because I don't have home. What you call your homemade thing is a tragedy for me. See? At least the things which are sold in the market, they are sold because they are tasty and better. Your house things, I have to say they are good because I have to survive. See, friends. Therefore, asad vikalpoyam vishvam iti ekavastuni, because nirvikare, nirakare, nirvisheshe vidakutha, where is the possibility of differences, which is without any form, without any modification, without any nirvisheshe, without any speciality. Be attentive. The speciality should be removed. You will see how speciality has gone deep in our head. You ask somebody, unknown person, "Hey, how are you?" "Oh, I am all right." "Then what's your name?" "Oh, my name is Vijay." Do we stop there? "Vijay, aage kya hai? Aage rasta hai?" No. Vijay Sharma. "No, wo theek hai, but which place?" "Karnataka." "Tamil Nadu." "How many visheshta?" And then you ask, "What is your name?" "Abdul Hamid." No further question. See? Nirvishesh. This visheshta creates a lot of differences. And we get only lost in that. Therefore, nirvikare nirakare nirvisheshe vidakutaha. Therefore, these wrong notions are most detrimental for our spiritual evolution. Drashtu darshana drushyadi bhavashunne niramaye kalparnava ityad ivatyantam paripurne chidatmane. Drashtu darshana drushyadi bhavashunne niramaye. Niramaye, no impurity, no health problem of that which is free from the trio of seer, seen and seeing. It is technically called a triputi. Every experience has got these three components: experiencer, experiencer and experienced. In that absolute reality, these three things are totally absent. This point we told you, that knowledge where a sense of otherness happens is mind. Are you there? "I don't know, there is no light here. How can I tell you?" No. We don't require light to know our being. "I can't hear. I don't know whether I am here or no." Our presence is established without any means of knowledge. That pramana nirapeksha anubhuti, that experience which doesn't demand the authority of any means of knowledge, that is our essential nature. Drashtu darshana drushyadi bhavashunya niramaye kalparnava ivatyantam paripurna chidatmani. And what is this? It is like the infinite ocean. Infinite can be experienced by dissolving the finite. And the finite can be dissolved by knowing that in the infinite, finite is only imagined. Man is infinite. The son is finite. The husband is finite. The father is finite. So the man has not become three, is only imagined. Then he is a son, he is a husband, he is a father. And in these four, son, husband, father and man, what is the reality? So in this infinite man, all multiplicity is only imagined, it is not real. See, friends, therefore, if you have to imagine, why don't you imagine, as a husband, I am happy, imagine. By this practice, you will come back to your manhood. So, drashtu darshana drushyadi bhavashunne niramaye kalparniva atyantam paripurna chidatmani. Is absolute existence, where there are no differences on any count, because the finite cannot be divided in parts. This is the meaning of the statement given in our scriptures, like Bhagavad Gita, when Bhagavan says, Mamai Vamsho Jiva Loke Jiva Bhuta Sanatanaha Manashashtanindriyani Prakriti Sthani Karshati. Mama Eva Amshaha, Paramatma, the infinite, he says, my part is Jiva. So infinite, when it cannot be particulate, when it cannot be divided in parts, then what can be done? We can imagine. The Jiva Bhava is imagined. It is not real. Reality is Paramatma. Like husband is not real, man is real. The sun is not real, the man is real. Exactly the same way. Jiva is not real, Paramatma is real. But without understanding this, we get caught up only in these non-essentials. See? Because we don't define what is a jiva. What is a husband? Man plus wife. As a result, whatever happens is husband. In the same manner, Paramatma plus Panchakoshas, an expression of Paramatma in the Panchakosha is Jiva, the soul. When the Panchakosha disappear, where the Jiva has gone? Nowhere. What is the light in the bulb? Light in the bulb is electricity. Body is bulb. Expression of electricity through the body of the bulb is light. Can you talk of light without reference to these two factors? No. In the same manner, Paramatma expressing through the bulb of the body as the light of the mind, the world is created. When the bulb loses its ability to express electrical energy as light, that bulb is called as fuse. Exactly the same way, when the body loses its ability to express consciousness as life, that body falls dead. You might have heard in many stories, somebody was dead and a Mahatmaji went and he touched him and he was again alive. One person asked me this question. I said, you know, there used to be bulbs. These days, those bulbs are very few. There used to be filament inside. And you are studying, if you are. And sometime at night, the bulb becomes fused. You can't do anything. So what we used to do, we used to play with the bulb. Move it this way, that way. And if the connection is established, immediately light comes. I said, that technique is known to those Mahatma. See, friends, the day you understand this principle, Jiva is not one per head. Jiva is nothing but expression of Paramatma through the Panchakoshas. So let the divinity fragrance be in our dealings. Therefore, how far we have come? Enough, I think. Kalparnava ivatyantam purne chidatmani. You are all hungry or what? Now there are still 45 minutes more. Oh God, yes. Tejasiva tamo yatra vilinam bhrantikaranam advitiye pare tatve nirvisheshe vidakutaha. Tejasi iva tamo. Like the darkness dissolves in the light and the darkness is the cause of all delusion, exactly in the same way, Bhrantikarana advitiye pare tatve nirvisheshe. In this absolute, there is neither darkness nor light. Wherever there is opposition, you are in samsara. Where there is no opposition, you are divine. See, my eyes are seeing the white color. They are not opposed to white. They are seeing the dark brown color. They are not opposed to dark brown. They see in the green color, not opposed to the green color. Therefore, the vision is divine. Then the mind entertains good thoughts, bad thoughts. Thoughts may be good and bad. Mind is never good and bad. Mind is indifferent to all thoughts. Last step, the conscious reality that we are is indifferent to waking, dream, deep sleep, samadhi. So what sadhana you want to do? Unopposed experience is abidance in the reality. But when the dream is going on, that time we never dream the dream as a dream. That time it is a solid reality. See? To such an extent, when there is some frightening dream, when we go, our heartbeat has increased, perspiration is happening. Then we get up, go to the washroom, open the fridge, drink something, eat something, walk here and there. That effect is still there. But still we know, no, it was not the real one. Like switch off the fan, the momentum keeps the fan moving for some time. Yet we don't take it as real. Be attentive. Exactly the same way, when we are awakened out of this waking dream, what is appearing to be a solid reality disappears. See, my friends, spiritual practice is the simplest thing in life. That is what we do. Tejasi vatamo yatra vilinam bhrantikaranam advitiye pare tatve nirvisheshe vidhakutaha. Advitiya pare tatve, non-dual absolute reality, nirvisheshe, non-specific. Therefore, again and again I am repeating this point. Don't imagine spiritual life is we are becoming extraordinary. No, we are remaining ordinary. Don't become extraordinary. See? The other day I happened to meet one lady in UK. She says, Swamiji, I sent you email, you never reply my email. I said, you are a secretary to a Swami. I never deal with the secretaries. If the Swami doesn't want to talk to me, I don't want to talk to him. Any Swami having a secretary is a corporate ananda. You must be open to everybody, open book. See, friends. There is no, I have to take permission from my secretary. Am I free that day? This I learned from one of the secretaries. It so happened, 2-3 times it happened because of my ability to forget. The same time, same date, I have given somebody for food, 2-3 people. Now how can I go to 2-3 places? So I had to cut a very sorry figure. So one amma told, Swamiji, I understand your problem, I'll do it for you. I said, okay, do it. After doing it for a few months, I came to know, suppose I told somebody, for some reason, I'll come to your house, okay? No, no, Swamiji, you cannot go. Because it is already fixed the other day. I said, okay. And yet I went, and what she has fixed, I have not gone there. Swamiji, you didn't go there. I said, I didn't go. I said, she said, why? I said, who are you? I don't recognize you. That day I understood, what is the meaning of secretary? Your freedom is lost. See? Many people ask the same question. Swamiji, you move around so many places, nobody goes with you, some seva. I said, I will have to do his seva. Uta ba, uta. Never compromise with your freedom in life. Otherwise, you will become a slave. And a slave can never be happy in life. Therefore, Like Mahabharatkar says, Sarvam Paravasham Dukkham, Sarvam Atmavasham Sukham, Etat Vidyat Samasena Lakshanam Sukadukkayoho. All dependence is misery, independence is happiness. Otherwise, you become extremely miserable. Ekatmake paretatve bhedakarta katham bhaven sushupto sukhamatrayam bhedakinava lokitaha. Ekatmake paretatve, that which is one without a second, in that who will create a what difference? It is we who say, waves, ocean, you ask the waters, Mr. Water, yes. As waves, you are very cute man, but as ocean, you are terrible. So what the water will say, excuse me, gentlemen, what is the ocean? And what is a wave? From the water standpoint, there is neither the ocean nor the wave. There is no bheda. See? So what is ocean and wave? Only words, without any meaning. Ocean means also water, wave also means water. But we have forgotten the original name and we have given our own names. And after we have given name, then we have to justify. So we say ocean is the cause, wave is the effect. In the waters, there is neither the ocean nor the waves, neither the cause nor the effect. Therefore, ekatmake pare tatve bheda karta katham bhavidu. Who will do the difference if there is only one? Imagine you go beyond the relationship of the sun and earth. Go away. Thereafter, which is the east, north, west, south? All the directions are with reference to the relationship between earth and the sun. If you go beyond the relationship, which is the earth, which is the south, which is the north? So, all the directions are only aupadhik, relational. They are not real. But we are so much influenced by that, then we become victim of feng shui. And everywhere, put those pyramids, everywhere. And after you put, keep the pyramid just behind your head, then you will get nice energy. So one person kept a pyramid. Which pyramid? If you make it, you know, metal pyramid, Sapta Dhatu, it is more powerful. Because that person has a lot of money, somehow to spend. He made a big pyramid with the Sapta Dhatu, right, behind his head. And while sitting, he slept, thak. And that pyramid has gone inside. Realization. This energy, vibration, these are the height of foolishness. It's nothing like that. You only go and imagine. See, that place was so powerful. Why? Higher electricity? No. This is powerful. All those places, many places I have gone on the issue of this thing. Swamiji, that particular place, it is so powerful with energy. So I went and came. He said, how did you feel? I said, I didn't feel anything. No, it is really very powerful. Now when you say 10 times, okay, powerful. See? Similarly, these people who bring their, what you call, the energy and they become the channel and they do something to your feet. In Uttarkashi, one lady said, we are very tired. Swamiji, I will do some energy healing to your feet. I said, look here, I am all right, don't try. No, I will do it. I said, okay. And she was trying something and she got such a big jerk. She was thrown on the wall behind. She said, Swamiji, what happened? I said, Sharshrakit. Don't try all this rubbish. That is not spirituality. You will get carried away by that. Therefore, this healing and then the magnet, this is not spirituality. Yoga, opening a studio, yoga studio, and crying, no students. देयरफॉर एकात्मके परे तत्वे भेदकर्ता कथम भवे सुषुप्तो सुखमात्रायाम भेदकेनावलोकितः. इन द डीप स्लीप व्हेन वी आर प्लंज इन टू डीप ब्लिस देयर एक्सपीरियंसर एक्सपीरियंस्ड एंड एक्सपीरियंस ऑल द डिविजन्स डिसअपियर एंड देयरफॉर wherever there is absolute happiness, there is absolute noise. And that is why people snore at night. Their snoring is Brahmanandam Paramasukadam. No fear. A man who doesn't open his eyes before his wife, forget about mouth. He snores loudly next to her. Where from that courage comes? Because merge in the infinite. Get out of this. Chitta moolo vikalpoyam chitta bhavena kashchanam atashchittam samadehi pratyak rupe paratmani. Now this is a very deep important slok. Chitta moolo vikalpoyam. All vikalpa, all the options are only in the mind. Chitta moolo vikalpoyam, chitta bhavena kashchana. When the mind is enfolded, then we are neither man nor woman. We are neither in India nor in Sri Lanka. We are neither in 2017 or 1947. Everything is leveled. So where is everything? It's only in the mind. This we have to just get a click of it. Anything which doesn't enter the mind doesn't exist for us. Simple rule. This particular thing I am telling you out of experience, not by reading books. Once there was something wrong with my right toe, like the strawberry, something was growing. Must be of the size of a peanut or little bigger than that. So one of my friends in Mumbai, when he did namaskar, he said, Swamiji, what is happening there? I said, this is called as wisdom toe. Ignorant people get wisdom tooth. The wise people get wisdom toe. He said, this is not a joke. It is not simple. You should get corrected quickly. I said, okay, I'll do it. He said, no, I am a doctor, I can do the operation. I said, come. Straight away from the lecture, I went to him. I said, where is your operation theater? He said, no, that is not a big operation. You sit in the chair. He kept a stool in front of me. I put my leg on that. He gave local anesthesia to my big toe. And after 15 minutes, he said, can you feel now? I said, no, nothing I feel. I am not sentimental. He said, no, I said, no feeling. Then he took the scalpel and he said, you can see now. And he straight away cut the toe from the front and then took the scalpel and like you take out the ice cream scoop, like when he put it down and he took it out. He said, you are lucky. It has come out completely. No roots are left. I saw that blood coming out, everything, no pain, because my toe was in chemical meditation. Mind was withdrawn from the toe. So where is everything? Everything is in the mind. When the mind dissolves, the world disappears. Vishvam darpana drishyamana nagari tulyam nijantargatam pashyannatmani mayaya bahirivod bhutam yathanidraya यस साक्षात कुरुते प्रबोध समये स्वात्मानमेवाद्वयम् तस्मै श्री गुरुमूर्तये नमः इदं श्री दक्षिणामूर्तये. दिस होल वर्ल्ड इज लाइक द रिफ्लेक्शन इन अ मिरर. इन द सेम मैनर दिस होल वर्ल्ड इज ओनली लाइक ए रिफ्लेक्शन इन द माइंड. When the mirror is removed, reflection disappears. When the mind is enfolded as in deep sleep, everything disappears. So everything is only in the mind. Kitta bhave na kashchana. When there is no mind, there is no world. Now you see other examples. When somebody is in coma, his mind is enfolded. He has no personality. But those who are alive, they have got personality. And they are fed up of paying the bills. So they call Swamis. Maharaji, we can't see her miseries, you know. 6 months she is still lying there in coma. We pray to the Lord, she should be relieved of the pain. I told her, look here, don't cheat yourself. She is not miserable. You are miserable. Every day 5,000. All the saving that she has kept for you, she is taking with her. A person who is in coma is never miserable. The person who is likely to go in coma because of paying the bills, he is miserable. Chitta bhavena kashchana ataha chittam samadehi pratyek rupe paratmani. Therefore, dissolve your mind in the pure consciousness. And the technique, give up the objectification of the subject. Objectless awareness is the truth. Therefore, let the mind dissolve in the pure consciousness. Meaning, anything which is experienced through the mind, just delete it. Anything. What is seen through the mind? Jagra, sapna, sushupti, samadhi. Waking, dream, deep sleep and samadhi. They are only in the mind. They come and go. And when this mind is dissolved in pure consciousness, there is neither waking, nor dream, nor deep sleep, nor samadhi, nor coma. Abiding in that is the meaning of spiritual practice. Before you all get out of your own, I'll stop here. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnahat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.